guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. I'm Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Oh, yes, in fact, indeed. That's not the place I want to be, actually. Believe it or not, that's not the place I want to go. Yeah. I'm picking and choosing. Okay, so we're gonna come over here. And you'll notice, I believe in the last episode I pointed out one of these on the UFO in the first room of this underwater area. There's a door with Kazooie's face on it. If we push Z, and then not push B because that returns it to Banjo. Let me get farther away so I can kind of demonstrate this a little bit more. If you push Z, Kazooie pumps out of the backpack like that, and you can kind of control her underwater. We picked this move up in the last episode, so if you didn't see that, go check it out. I'm not entirely sure what's in here, believe it or not, but, I guess we'll find out. More eels? Really? More eels? Didn't we, like, deal with those in the last episode? Nah, don't chase me. Hey, look at a pirate, too. Ow! A very aggressive pirate! Get out of here. Dick. Now I'm gonna point something out here. There is a Cheeto page. Oop, yeah, there it is right there. There's a Cheeto page up there. And I'm gonna kind of show you a way to get it before you have the right moves to get it with. There's a move from a later world, a much later world, that you can get to. Oh, hello. Well, aren't you very Minjo-ish, aren't you? Yeah. Alright. Sorry. There's a move you can get from a later world, a much later world, that will allow you to get that. But if you come over here with either Banjo or Kazooie, actually, I don't think you can do it with Kazooie. But there was a way you can get it with just Banjo, so we're gonna do that right now. Eel, avoid the eel. Now, this is kind of a bit of a cheat, and I don't know if I can pull it off. Actually, oh, well, no, hang on, I fucked that up. Can I do it like this? No, I cannot. I'm sorry, I'm a noob at this. But, like, this is literally the only thing you get in this building, is a Cheeto page. So I'm just gonna get it. Well, there we go. So basically, if you jump, press B to use your pack-whack, and then jump again, you do, like, this pack-whack jump, as they call it. There's a move you get later on with Kazooie that allows you to get over there pretty easily, I believe. A couple moves, actually. You need a total of 3 moves with Kazooie to get here. You need the one to get through the door, then you need the one to do the little... I don't want to spoil anything, but the backflip thing, and then the move to fly over there. So, like, it just seems, like, very trivial for that one Cheeto page, so I might as well just pick it up now. That kind of deal. Alright, so what was that other building that I didn't go into? It was over here, I believe. This is actually, I believe, where we want to go, because it'll lead us to a new area, I think. We've pretty much gotten everything in this area, believe it or not. You'll probably notice that there's a couple, like, tunnels or something around the edge that take you to other places. We'll probably go to those, but most likely we'll end up just coming back to this main room through those, because, like, everything in this world kind of wraps around. I believe there's even one that leads you back to the first room. Oh, look at these seaweed things. Holy shit! They come to life! And then you dice them up. Look at that. It looks like, I don't know what it looks like, but I don't care. That's kind of creepy. This room is kind of creepy altogether, because it's all green. Like it's like the algae went so far as to not only coat the walls in green, but coat the light in green, too. But I suppose light bounces off the walls. Stuff and science. Is that a note down there? I'm not gonna jump back down. Although I believe there are notes around here somewhere. Are they up there? Dude, get out of the first person view, man. You were just not very good at this. Alright, I can't go that way. I feel like there, oh, well, there's a Jinjo in here. Knowing this level, it's probably a Minjo, though. Where is he? He's way over there, isn't he? Yeah, he is. So I have to go all the way around. That's okay, because we like walking, don't we, Banjo? Banjo disagrees with walking, because he's a fat ass. No, this can't be a ninja, because the ninja doesn't have enough room to rock around. There we go, finally. It's another brown ninja. We've got one more brown ninja to get, and then we'll get a Jiggy. Happy face. Alright. So here we go. Like I said, this leads us to another area. Possibly underwater again, because that's just how... Oh, no, we're above water. That's interesting. Where is this? Sea bottom? Okay. Oh, I see. We're in this place. Well, this is quite the doozy of a place, isn't it? Now, there's a couple things in here. You're gonna notice, first of all, there's these fish that are kind of clear. You can get those by using Kazooie Torpedo, whatever the hell it's called. Regal Torpedo, or whatever. But, and there are fish that have important things in them, but right now we're not gonna worry about that because that one's only golden feathers. I just want to point that out, just to know that I will be getting those. Turn around. Turn around. Now, what you want to do here is, I believe, shoot grenade eggs at this guy's teeth. But it's quite difficult. Actually, let me get that warp pad first. GTFO my face, man! GTFO! Get your teeth all up in my face. No, I don't want to... I don't want to warp. I want to swim. There we go. Yeah, this guy's not that difficult. Well, I mean, you're not fighting him or anything. Well, unless you're shooting yourself, then you're not really fighting him, you're fighting yourself. Alright, this... Wow, jeez. I don't remember whose LP I was watching. It might have been the Tentacle Sons, but whoever it was, they ran out of grenades, or they were running out of grenades. And it was kind of laughable, because it's just not that difficult to hit them. I think it might have been the Tentacle Sons, because he had a really shitty controller for his LP. Now, if this guy would, like, turn or something, so I can get in front of him, maybe? I wish I could swim faster. Oh, I can. Durf! Yeah, that's another thing you get alongside the double bubbles. Which I'm glad that I actually got that now, because you can, in fact, swim faster. I just didn't remember when you got it in the game. I guess it was also along with the double bubbles. Yeah, if you hold down A and B. I guess I didn't mention that. I didn't read the thing properly. Dude, you need to get in front of friggin' Jabu Jabu here. Jabu Jabu's evil twin brother with giant spiky teeth. There we go, and he opens his fist wide like his fish. He opens his fist. Really? Okay. No, just no. Ah, so here we are, inside the big fish, inside Jabu Jabu's belly. This is kind of nasty, actually. IMO. And if you go to the right path, down this path here, in his, like, esophagus, there is a Jinjo! It's a purple Jinjo! Hi there. I wish it was a brown Jinjo. That would have made me lol, because this would be in his intestines. No. Actually, this way is probably his intestines. Ew. No, that's his esophagus. This is his stomach. Ew. Who the hell is this?
Oh, you must be the rescue party.
Only if the price is right.
I'm Mary Maggie, partner of Jolly Roger.
Hey, it's Jolly Roger's partner.
I was out in one of Blubber's wave races when the fish knocked me off and swallowed me.
The fish's mouth is open now.
So you don't have to stay in here. That's lovely. It'll
soon be happy hour at the inn, and Jolly will be needing some relief.
Any chance of a Jiggy?
Oh, see Jolly about that. I'm sure he'll give you one.
It's funny, though, because most of the characters in this game, especially in the first one, didn't know what a Jiggy was. Like, they were all like, oh, this shiny thing, this trinket, this whatever. This is, like, one of the few characters that actually acknowledged that it's a Jiggy. Like,
any chance you get a Jiggy? Yeah, no, go ask Jolly.
Anywho, so yeah, we've saved Jolly's partner. I suppose we could go pick up the Jiggy for that now, since we haven't really gotten many Jiggies in this world yet. Why the hell not? We've got a warp pad down here anyway, so we can just come back. I kind of want to get this all in one thing. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Now I gotta find the warp pad. Where the hell is it? Oh, there it is. Dole. Yeah, suddenly I already run out of stuff to say, man. Alright, so we're gonna go back to Town Center. We're gonna come right back down here so we can continue from the same room, so we don't get lost. Actually, I might go back to just Atlantis, because I think we're pretty much done in that one room. Let's go visit Jolly. This is like the one Jiggy that we'll be getting up here right now. Hey, there's Mary Maggie.
Thanks for rescuing me from the bile-infested innards of that ferocious sea monster.
Actually, he was just a very large fish.
It seemed like a monster to me. Thanks for rescuing my partner.
Think nothing of it.
No, honestly, I'm rather pleased. How about a tanker of my finest ginger beer? On the house?
Perhaps later.
Then please accept this modest little trinket instead.
Yeah, see? Trinket. Like, he doesn't even know what's called the juggy. He's like, oh, this is a thingy. It's a thing. He, like, can't remember nouns. He can't remember nouns, even though trinket is a noun. Alright, anyway. So let's just go back to the under the sea. Under the sea. Yes, you don't have to tell me twice. I'm just gonna go to regular Atlantis, because I don't believe there's anything in the big fish's room. No, what? Dummy. Yeah, you didn't have to freaking teleport there. Anywho, so we've done everything in this... Well, we're making some great progress in these last couple episodes. We've done everything in... Whoa, blowfish! What are you doing, man? Not blowfish, but puffer fish. Dude!
Dude! 2 times in a row, man! 2 times in a row! I tried to drink water and it just sounded less out of my face!
Yeah, why the hell not? We're picking places here. And this seems like the logical choice. There's probably a octopus in here or something. I don't see one. So we might be in the clear. In the clear. Oh, I think I know what this... Oh, I think I know what room this is. Oh, and there's a Jiggy right there. I hear a Globo. And it's down there. But you know what? We will get that Globo next time. Because right now, I'm going to get this Jiggy, and I think I'm going to end the episode. No, don't push B. I was, like, lined up perfectly, you stupid fool. You stupid fool. Oh, this can be pretty impossible to get, actually, believe it or not. Because I believe you can't just, like, go slowly through it. There we go. Alright, go back to Banjo here. So, let me just check here and see how many, total... Let's see my totals here. I've got all the things already. There's one more Jinjo, and I think I... Oh, actually, I know where it is. One more Cheeto page, which I can't seem to remember. And one more, thingy. Although I still need to get the other two empty honeycomb pieces. And I have an idea of where they are. I know at least where one of them are, but I'm not sure where the other one is right now. I'm sure I'll find it, though. Alright, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I think I'll end it there, because the thing I want to do in the next episode, I kind of want to carry it all over. And, yeah, you can see Humba's place up there. Submerged in water. We'll get the Jinjo... Not the Jinjo, the... Not the Minjo. What is this thing called again? Globo! For the love of Christ! Get your words straight, man. Jesus, Grandma! See you next time, guys.